AMD's Navi 22 GPU based on the RDNA 2 graphics architecture has been spotted in the latest Linux patches by Komachi. The Navi 22 GPU is part of a next-generation RDNA 2 graphics lineup, which is expected to feature at least three new GPUs and several variants based on those chips for use in Radeon RX as well as Radeon Pro Series discrete graphic designs. Now, the first product based on the AMD RDNA 2 graphics architecture is expected to arrive either by the end of Q3 or Q4 this year, and there are three products that AMD has confirmed with RDNA 2 architecture for this year, and that include the highly anticipated Big Navi GPU, which is said to utilize the Navi 21 GPU core, and there's two custom designs which will go in to power the new consoles for Microsoft with the Xbox Series X and Sony PlayStation 5. The AMD Navi 21 and Navi 23 GPU have already been spotted previously, but a new Navi 22 GPU is an interesting one. The chip has been spotted again in the latest Linux patches and are reported first by Calocanth Dream. Over at the blog, it is reported that the first set of Linux kernel patches has been spotted and that adds support for AMD's next generation RDNA 2 GPU, which is codenamed Navi Flounder. It's an interesting one. Now, there are interesting things to consider with the listed patch that mentions Navi Flounder GPUs, so we can expect several SKUs for the Navi 22 GPU, not just one particular configuration, which is a common practice by GPU manufacturers. The chip falls in the GFX 10.3 architecture generation, which is commonly referred to as the GFX 103X series for RDNA 2 chips. The Navi 21 GPU is based on the GFX 1030, while the Navi 23 GPU is based on the GFX 1032 graphics architecture. So one will assume that the Navi 22 GPU be based on the GFX 1031 architecture. Now it seems like AMD has become more fond of fish codenames for its RDNA 2 GPUs, but we know these codenames are just for internal use, as stated in the Arcturus GPU, which featured a revised Vega graphics core based on the new CDNA design for high power computing. AMD still sticks with their star codenames for its GPU lineup, which is evident by the use of Navi for three generations of GPUs, so Navi 1X, 2X, and 3X. The blog also reports that some more major design changes for the Navi 22 Navi Flounder GPU compared to Navi 21, which was the Sienna Cichlid GPU. The use of VCN 3.0, that's the Video Core Next, and DCN 3.0, which is Display Core Next, reaffirms this that is an RDNA 2 GPU, but they're supporting evidence that Navi 22 is a lower tier chip even compared to Navi 21. For starters, Navi 22 GPU only features one instance of the VC3 versus two on Navi 21. Also, the SDMA controllers have dropped to two compared to four on the Navi 21. There's also the assumption that made that since Navi 22 would be a direct follow-up to the Navi 12 GPU, it could primarily be targeted at an Apple Mac design. The Navi 12 GPU-powered Radeon RX 5600M is the first and only RDNA 2 graphics chip to make use of HBM2 memory design and featured in the Radeon Pro lineup. It's also used primarily for Apple's Mac and hasn't launched in the desktop space. Now, AMD could take the same route with Navi 22 GPU, but since the Linux patch mentions Navi Flounder GPUs, we could see a consumer release too, not just a purely Apple exclusive launch this time around. Now, previous rumors have also suggested the die size of around 340mm² for Navi 22 GPU, but that's pure speculation at this point. We still have no details to actual specifications for AMD's RDNA 2 consumer graphics cards. Now, rumors have also suggested that both NVIDIA and AMD are planning their next generation flagship gaming cards to hit the streets by September of 2020. So it looks like AMD's RDNA 2 GPUs would compete against whatever NVIDIA's next generation GPU inventory ends up being. Q3 and Q4 of 2020 is definitely going to be an interesting time for the hardware enthusiasts and mainstream PC gamers who are looking to upgrade their computers to the latest and greatest. For more on this and other news, follow the link in the description and make sure you're subscribed and hit the notification bell so that we don't miss you in the next one.